I will pass the microphone to Asad Aleem, who is a senior energy specialist at the Asian Development Bank, based in the Philippines, in Manila. But Asad is based in Kabul, Afghanistan. And I think you have the right outlook on the Central Asian energy projects.
Thank you very much, Professor Radu. Okay, you know, Asian Development Bank has a strong presence adjoining the Caspian countries. In energy sector, we are the largest development partner in Turkmenistan, in Kazakhstan, in Azerbaijan. And the remaining two, Russia and Iran, are not members of ADB, so we have no interest in host countries. Then in the adjoining countries, we have investments. We are assisting Uzbekistan, Tajikistan, Kyrgyz Republic, Pakistan, Afghanistan, then Armenia, Georgia. Now, to give you a perspective, the countries adjoining Caspian, now Iran is, as per the British Petroleum Report 2013, it has the largest proven reserves. Russia has the second largest proven reserves. Turkmenistan has the fourth largest proven reserves. And Uzbekistan further down at 19th number. In terms of oil, Iran has Iran is number 4, Iraq number 5, Russia is number 8, Kazakhstan is number 11. I'll start with Turkmenistan. I'm based in Kabul and I monitor projects in Turkmenistan, in Tajikistan, in Pakistan. Now in Turkmenistan, ADB has been the secretariat of TAPI. TAPI is Turkmenistan, Afghanistan, Pakistan, India pipeline. Now for the past 15 years, we are working on this project and had scores of meetings. Every 3 months, there is a meeting of the four countries. As of now, this pipeline is about 1,800 kilometers, starts from southern, southeastern Turkmenistan, goes through Afghanistan into Pakistan and then India and Fazilka. Capacity is 33 BCM, and the cost is about $8 billion as per the prices of 2008, it risen to about 11 billion now. Pakistan and India will get 15 BCM each and Afghanistan 3 BCM. And Secretary Clinton in 2011, she unveiled this Asian roundabout, or they have a more focus towards Afghanistan. And because of the security reasons, so that's why Turkmen is more looking eastwards. And there's a strong push from ADB as well, because of our board, that we should complete or finance the projects which look eastwards. Unfortunately, in TAPI, now Turkmenistan does not allow onshore drilling by the international companies. So the engagement with Total is now ongoing for a few years, and it is hoped that Total would be given the contract to develop the fields which would eventually provide gas to these eastern countries. In terms of exports to China, now sure, Turkmenistan wants to diversify, and I'll talk about power as well. About 2 weeks back, ADB facilitated a power purchase and sales agreement between Turkmenistan and Afghanistan for 500 megawatt for the next 10 years. And in fact, Turkmenistan has already built the power lines up till the border of Afghanistan. And they are eyeing the Tajikistan, Pakistan, and Afghanistan markets. So it is like gas to power, and then it will be exported. On the Afghan side, ADB is building the infrastructure, and it will be operational from 2018. And at a very competitive price, which is much better than CASA and other regional projects happening. In terms of Chinese lines, the lines were built in 18 months. It started in 2008, was completed in 2009. It's the same length as TAPI. But TAPI has taken 15 years and is still not off the ground. And it's 40 BCM which is being supplied by the two Chinese parallel lines through Kazakhstan and Uzbekistan into China. And Kazakhstan also adds 5 BCM, and Uzbekistan is adding 10 BCM into that. And the third line is under construction since 2011, for which is another 25 BCM for China. So it would, in total, in a couple of years, it will be 65 BCM, which will be imported from Turkmenistan into China. And adding 5 and 10 again from Uzbekistan and Kazakhstan. Looking westwards, now the Caspian link. The model which Turkmenistan employs is that it puts all burden to the importing countries to develop the pipelines. Like we have seen in TAPI, which is the major cause of delay, that they have to fund the transaction advisors, they have to do the financial closure, and the burden is on the importing countries. So I would see that the Caspian link is not going to happen very soon. First of all, Turkmenistan, because of the reasons I mentioned, is viewing China and the eastern markets. And then due to opposition from Iran and Russia, Caspian, and to find the investors, that's a big question mark. I don't think so, in that in the coming 10 years or so, this project would even take off from the ground. Now, Uzbekistan is 80% of the gas is used for its own consumption. Uzbekistan is also eyeing power markets in the power hungry, Afghanistan, Pakistan, Tajikistan. They have a disputed relationship, but eventually they have to export power. As of now, the gas, the developed gas is depleting, and even in winter, they have to shed their own customers for power in order to export to countries like Afghanistan. So until and unless new investments are made in Uzbekistan, I don't think so they have any plans or potential to export and gas either to east or west. Kazakhstan, as I mentioned earlier, has already provided is providing gas to China, and it's the second biggest oil country in the former Soviet Republic. So so it's more inclined towards oil production. Azerbaijan, I'm sure my colleague here would talk more about that. But the Southern Gas Corridor and Shah Deniz further investments and development would eventually open the markets for the Western countries. I think I would stop here, and maybe at the end, if there is a need be, I'll talk more on the projects. Thank you.